Today we're looking at the late 90s children's show Aquila, which was created by television maestro Andrew Norriss. Some of his work includes Aquila, Matt's Million, Bernard's Watch. He also adapted the book Woof, which focuses on a boy who can turn into a dog. A concept so exciting, the title has an exclamation mark. Aquila is a series about three things: friendship, family, and an alien spaceship that's found in a cave. As unlikely as this mix seems, this is precisely why Aquila is so endearing. It's the combination of resoundingly ordinary, everyday circumstances and remarkably extraordinary situations that gives the show a certain pizzazz. The first episode is called The Eagle Has Landed, and top fact, Aquila means eagle in Latin. So our two protagonists, Tom and Jeff, are on holiday. Jeff falls down a hole, Tom comes to help, and they uncover an alien spaceship. The rest of the series focuses on their attempts to keep Aquila a secret while also discovering all the things the ship can do. One thing I love about this is the sense of progression. At the start, Tom and Jeff don't know all of Aquila's secrets, but as the series progresses, so does their understanding of the ship. They find a part that's missing, they start to experiment with the buttons on Aquila's dashboard, and they keep a journal that lists the ship's numerous functions. By the end of the series, Tom and Jeff, and we as the viewers, have learned that Aquila has a laser, a grappling beam, it can turn invisible, all kinds of cool stuff. Speaking of progression, this also applies to the characters, or specifically to Tom. He starts the series as a bit of a coward. He's far too cautious, and he doesn't even want to pilot Aquila himself.
There's nothing to be frightened of. Flying 100 miles in the dark in something you found in a hole in the ground. I think there is, Jeff.
However, throughout the series, Tom gains a lot more confidence, and the series ends with this charming scene.
I thought it might be fun to collect a few rocks.
Rocks?
Right. From... from there.
Wow!
The second series goes into more detail about Aquila's origins. We find out it's an escape pod from an alien battlecruiser, which will soon be close enough for Tom and Jeff to visit. Back on Earth, we find out more about the life of a Roman centurion who piloted the ship 1600 years ago. His skeleton was found with Aquila back in the first episode. It's revealed that the centurion used Aquila to kill and steal, after which he... well, I'll let Jeff explain.
He spent the next 4 days staying with some women in Cirencester.
I think we're going to have to hear that one again.
He spent the next 4 days staying with some women in Cirencester.
He laid with some women in Cirencester. I think laid is the optimal word here. I think it's very easy if you're writing for children to get lazy, and there's nothing more lazy than pandering to kids with the age-old joke of the kids are smart and the adults are stupid. For the most part, Aquila avoids this and plays it fairly straight. For example, there's an episode where Tom and Jeff's teachers find their Aquila journal, and after building it up like they figured out what's going on, it turns out they just think the boys have vivid imaginations. This doesn't make the adults look stupid, if anything it makes them look normal. In real life, adults tend to rationalise bizarre events, much as the teachers do in this episode, while kids are more unquestioning, as shown in Tom and Jeff's easy acceptance of an alien spaceship. This is a pretty clever concept for a kid show, but this is something Aquila does best. It doesn't dumb anything down for children. The Centurion subplot is a great example. It allows the show to talk about responsibility and how Aquila can be used for either good or evil without being ham-fisted. These bigger themes are something the series does exceptionally well, and I think there are two episodes in particular that highlight this. In the first episode of the second series, Jeff starts joking about how he always forgets his dad's birthday, and Tom responds with this.
How'd you feel if it was your birthday? There's no present and your dad comes along 2 days later and says, oh, I'm sorry, I forgot to post it.
This is solid, because as a kid, I just assumed Tom was making a point, but as an adult, it's obvious Tom is projecting based on his own situation. It turns out his dad left when he was 3 years old. The episode ends with Tom flying to his dad's house in Australia to look around.
Tom? I said if you want to wait here in case anyone turns up.
No, it's okay. I've seen what I wanted.
We immediately understand that Tom's concern is that his father doesn't care about him anymore, and rather than communicating this through reams of exposition-heavy dialogue, this is instead resolved with one line and one image. That is great. In my opinion, the standout episode of the entire run is episode 5 in the first series, entitled Losing Power. Aquila starts shutting down, and there's nothing Tom and Jeff can do about it. They think of various solutions, but none of them actually work. Listen to the words Jeff uses in this scene.
It's died. That's why I couldn't get any further. Even before I landed, I could feel it. Then it lurched to one side, and all the lights went out, and it wasn't alive anymore.
This kind of anthropomorphic language is clearly intentional because, surprise, the whole episode is really about loss, and this really stuck with me as a kid. The concept of having something you love, which then starts to fade away, is one nearly everyone can relate to, and while the episode has a happy ending, the fact they're even broaching this subject in a series about a magic alien spaceship is impressive. On a more lighthearted note, Aquila is full of little incidental things that are really good. In one episode, Jeff finds out that Aquila has the equivalent of a video black box that has been recording for hundreds of years, and he says this.
I've run through the first couple of hundred years, and all they're doing is building a pyramid.
He saw the Great Pyramids being built, and he's like, eh, whatever. Brilliant. In the first series, Tom and Jeff briefly lose Aquila because one of the buttons gets jammed. They're both terrible at maths, so they trick a teacher into helping them by presenting their problem like one of those awful KS2 maths questions every kid will remember from school.
If an object sets off at 8:45 and travels 160 metres by 10:1, how long would it take it to cover another 134 metres?
Towards the end of the second series, Tom discovers a function on the ship that shows if people are lying, and this leads him to believe his mum's boyfriend Alan hasn't been truthful about who he is or what he does for a living. When Tom confronts Alan about this, it turns out he was telling completely innocent white lies.
I was christened, as the document says, Percival Ivanhoe Pritchard. Now believe me, Tom, that is not a name to go to school with. When I was 5, I decided my name was Alan.
This is brilliant because the show doesn't chastise Alan. In fact, it's actually saying that sometimes lying is okay. That is pretty ballsy for a kids' show. Finally, there's an episode where Aquila gives Tom a super-powered lizard arm, and it's awesome. You'd think a series about an alien spaceship would be crazy enough, but Aquila actually goes a lot further. Take Miss Murray, for example. She's Tom's neighbour, and after she correctly figures out what Tom and Jeff are up to, they decide to tell her the truth to avoid her thinking she's gone bonkers. This is a nice gesture, except it turns out she sees an imaginary native Indian called Chief Running Water, and is in fact proper mental. Then, of course, there's the soundtrack, which is completely balls to the wall. Finally, in the episode where Aquila starts slowly moving forward of its own accord, at one point it's hovering invisibly above a playing field. This leads to an amazing shot. Oh my god, that needs a replay. Yep, he's dead. He's straight up dead. Roll the credits. I'm just kidding. I actually love that bit. And look at Jeff's reaction.
Yes!
Doesn't give a crap. I've got a confession to make. While I love Aquila, I have an ulterior motive for doing this review. Episode 2 from the second series is based at the boys' school, and guess what? I'm in the episode. The school the boys go to in the series is actually Cannon Lane Primary and Middle School, which is where I went as a kid. I actually know most of the people in the background of this episode, particularly this guy. So in this episode, a Scottish kid starts at the school, and he immediately picks a fight with Tom.
You walked a bad fit, Luke. Nobody walks a bad fit. Only have you.
So this kid won't be deterred, and he sets a time and a place for Tom to fight him.
You belier!
Tom decides he doesn't actually want to fight the child version of Dennis Taylor, and so, after grappling with the situation, decides the obvious thing to do is to use Aquila to literally murder him. I'm just kidding, they knock him out and drag him into a cupboard. Their plan is simple, they'll knock him out for 15 minutes, and when he comes to, he'll have missed the fight and everyone will assume he deliberately didn't turn up. This is actually a pretty good idea, except, plot twist, they've knocked out the entire school. Can we play that last one again? That seems highly improbable. So it turns out they set Aquila's attack range to be 300 cm, but Aquila thinks a cm is something called a collimort, which is considerably longer than a centimetre. Fortunately, everyone in the school is unharmed, although they do have to put out a fire, and also there's this.
Well, there's a boy in the toilets that's going to be very embarrassed when he wakes up.
Remember that line. So they change the clocks back to when everyone passed out, everyone wakes up, and amazingly, they get away with it. Except there's the small matter of the kid in the toilet. That kid? The kid with the piss all over his pants? That's me. Look at that acting, child sensation. In the end, their plan fails and Tom simply decides not to show up to the fight. Even though a few people think he's a chicken, he doesn't care, because while he has no power over what other people think, he does have the power to make his own decisions. It's a really nice ending, because it's saying one very important thing. In life, some people are going to be dicks no matter what, but it's your choice how you deal with them. The show doesn't go with the easy option of having Aquila make everything better, and that's pretty commendable. These kinds of non-preachy, honest life lessons are rife throughout the series and, along with a great premise and great storylines, contribute towards making Aquila one of the best children's series ever made. Prior to making this video, on a whim, I decided to contact the creator, Andrew Norriss. To my complete surprise, he actually replied and wrote a few things I should mention. First, Aquila was directed wonderfully by the late David Bell, someone Andrew describes himself as a good man. Second, the fire in the school episode was caused by a teacher's pipe setting fire to a pile of homework. You definitely don't see that anymore. Finally, Andrew Norriss signed off his email with this. It is so nice to get an email from someone who remembers the series with an obvious affection, as I do myself. I keep meaning to write volumes 3, 4 and 5 as books, but have never quite got round to it. In the meantime, thank you for your work to preserve the series. Very best, Andrew. What an absolute legend.